my channel. My name is Gabrielle Gay. So today we're going to be talking about the top three things that you, yes, you need for 2022. So keep on watching. So these principles are biblical, but they're also universal, right? Because they're all based on positive energy and just being the best that you can be. So let's get into number one. The first success principle that you need to be able to take over and navigate 2022 successfully is one, be bold and courageous. So what does that look like? Our first success principle is based on the story of Joshua and Caleb when they were, you know, seeking to take over Canaan as God told them to. So they sent out, you know, they sent out spies, so Moses, they sent out spies to the city of Canaan, you know, just to pre-vibe them, okay, and see exactly what was going on and what was needed to overtake the city. But out of those 12 spies, only two, Joshua and Caleb, were interested in actually taking over the city. The other 10, they were so afraid that it actually ended up discouraging the entire camp. And it took them 40 years to do something that literally could have been done in a matter of days or weeks. How does that apply to us in 2022? There is something you, that's you that's watching this right now, there's something that you were supposed to start in 2021 that you haven't started as yet. Yup. Is it that business? Is it that YouTube channel? And that's me speaking to myself, by the way, because I was supposed to start this since 2021. So we're in this together. But you're watching me right now. Which means that I had to take that bold and courageous step to revive, revamp, and start my YouTube channel back again. So what is it? That passion that you have that just bursts your heart with flames, why aren't you doing it? You're supposed to be bold and courageous, like Joshua and Caleb, and surge into that new territory that God has put here for you to do. Because that purpose, that thing that you're so scared of, He's going to use that, and He's going to use you to change other people's lives, okay? So, for example, in the pandemic, God gave me the idea of the FemLab cohort, which connects, you know, young women from small island developing states, marginalized communities, minorities, to all the legal resources and certification in entrepreneurship that they need. And that was a huge step because it was the first, and it is the first and only of its kind in the Caribbean Americas where I'm from. So that was really big. It was very scary. I didn't have a blueprint. I just had myself and God. But it was extremely successful. And if you want to find out more about that, I'll have all the information in the description bar below. But I had to take the first step. And that's something that you're not doing. Look, can we be real here? Can we talk to one another? Can we just, you know, connect and just be real here? That's what you're not doing. That's your huge idea. That's what you need to do to take yourself and other people to the next level. And you're not doing it. And that's why you feel stagnant. And that's why you feel as if you're not progressing. Were you supposed to leave that job? Yep. Were you supposed to go into entrepreneurship? Or were you supposed to switch jobs into something else that's more fulfilling? Were you supposed to change that major? Were you supposed to start school? Were you supposed to leave that toxic relationship that you know, girl or guy, that's not for you? You're going along, things are okay on the surface, but deep down, you know. So what is it that you have to do to be bold and courageous to start your destiny? I want you to write it down and get started on it today. Don't pressure yourself. Just write it down, make the vision plain, and get started on it today. Even if it's just the idea. Write it down. That makes it real. So success principle number two is accountability. Accountability. It is really amazing to have a great plan, to know that, you know, you have this huge destiny and this passion that you want to just take over the world with. But I promise you, if you don't have accountability where you hold yourself responsible, then it's just not going to work. Our success principle is based on the story of Cain and Abel, and I'll leave the passages right here so you can check it out. But basically, he killed his brother. Yeah, pretty intense. He killed his brother, and when God was about to punish him, instead of him saying, wow, you know, I'm the first murderer, which is not the Guinness World Record that we're trying to set here, like, no. Instead of saying, you know, I'm the first murderer and that's not cool, you know, I'm really sorry about my sin, you know what he said? He said, God, this punishment that you're giving me is a bit much. This is a lot and I can't handle it. That's what he said. Instead of taking accountability to be better, he was more worried about the fact that he got caught. True narcissist behavior. You've experienced a narcissist, you know how it is. He was more worried about the fact that he got caught and he was about to be punished than the fact that he had murdered his brother. Now, you may be saying, okay, but I'm not a murderer. I'm not a criminal. So what does this have to do with me? Okay, it does. It does. Let's use the example of having a terrible boss at work. This person is miserable. This person just treats you terribly. Oh, it is not the best situation ever, right? So, trust me, I can relate. I've been there. But what are you doing to preserve your inner peace? So what does that look like? It can be, you know, strengthening your devotion and walk with Christ and your inner peace. You know, doing guided, you know, meditations, positive affirmations in the morning. Or simply, it literally can go to 0 to 100 to the fact that you just have to leave that job. Like, sometimes you just have to get out of that situation. But for many people, they're not interested in the discomfort, right, of looking for something new. They're just not interested. They're not interested. They don't want to do it. No, wait, hold, stay. It's terrible, but I'm comfortable here, so I'm going to stay. If that sounds like you, it means that you definitely need accountability. Because once you recognize your power and you become self-aware in the situation that you are in, your life is going to change because you're not going to stand for it. You are going to pray, you're going to sit down, you're going to figure out and say, okay, what is the next step? What can I do to take myself out of this negative and toxic situation? Do I need help? Do I need advice? You know, should I go to a career counselor? That's what accountability looks like. It's not victim blaming. It's not blaming yourself and being unhealthy and saying, oh, it's me, it's all my fault. You know, okay, well, sometimes, I'm just saying, you may have to say that. But sometimes it may really be your fault, right? But the key is to look at the scenario and see how you can be better because of it. And the final success principle to help you have a productive and incredible 2022, coming in hot at number three, is know yourself. Sounds simple, right? But that is one of the hardest things, one of the hardest things to do, you know, in this lifetime, is to know yourself, okay? Why I say that's the most important is because until you spend time, and literally, I mean, just take some time, whether that be a day out of the week, a few hours out of every day, or a few hours every single week, just really sit down and have a self-reflective moment going into 2022. Who am I? Who am I? What do I love? What would I do with my life if I wasn't concerned about other people's opinion? Where do I want to go? What do I want to achieve? What is the mark, the legacy that I want to leave on this earth after I'm gone? Because the answers to these questions are going to shape your accountability process, and it's going to shape how bold and courageous you are in going after what you desire for 2022. So I believe in you. I know you are going to kill it. I know this year can be your year. Follow these principles, do the research, be bold and courageous, take accountability for your actions, both bad and good, and take the time, most importantly, to know yourself. You are going to be unstoppable. So, thank you so much for watching this video. Please be sure to leave a comment down below. What was your favorite success principle? What do you plan to do? Now, what are your ideas for 2022? And please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you want more motivational videos, new videos every single Monday. And I will catch you guys in another video. Bye, guys.